Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's OneDrive video, I'm going to cover five frequently asked questions that I get asked about OneDrive. Microsoft OneDrive is Microsoft's cloud storage platform that works with Microsoft 365. It is probably the best place to store files that you need just for yourself, or you're only sharing with few people and you want to control who you share with. Let's get into this right now. Question number one is, how do I add a file to OneDrive? I already have OneDrive running. I've already made a folder called Test Share, in case you're wondering how in the world did I make that folder. I hit New, I hit Folder, and I typed in Test Share. I can drag and drop files into OneDrive, but since I'm recording and my screen's taken up, I'm going to go to Upload Files. I'm going to just jump over to my desktop. And when I go to my desktop, here is a file called Test Chris Menard. I'm going to hit Open, and it uploads that file. I could have selected multiple files at one time. Not a problem. By default, when you upload a file to OneDrive, it is your file and your file only. That's why it wants to share over there to the right in case I wanted to share it, but I don't in this case right now. Question two. I did files. Well, can you upload a folder to OneDrive? And if so, how? Sure. Upload folder. Again, I could drag and drop if I want to. Here's a folder. I happen to know that it's got three files in it, so I'm going to hit upload. Yep, I do trust it. Upload. Perfect. One folder, three files right there. It's even telling me I got three items in it just to show it to you. Click here. There are the three files. Back to my folder. So I uploaded a file and I uploaded a folder that had three files. Question three is a great one, and this has to do with the slight difference in your OneDrive personal versus OneDrive for work or school. The question is, why can't I block download file? So here you go, in case you're wondering how to share a file, because this has to do with sharing. Three easy ways to share. One, there's the share icon there. Two, there's the share icon there. It's the same. Three, if you click here, there's share there. It doesn't matter how you do it. If you recall, when I uploaded it, wanted to share. Same screen. Click here. Here you go. Anyone with the link can edit. Click this little arrow. There are all my options right here, there. By default, edit, allow editing is the default. So you really have two different modes. You can either allow people to edit, or you can make it read only / view only. Watch this. If I turn this off, that's how you go from allow editing to allow just to view or read only. The question was, how can I block download? And the answer is right here. You can't block a download if you want people to edit. So you have to turn off allow editing. Now I can block someone from downloading this Microsoft Excel file. They can only view it. They can't do anything else with it. And I would hit apply. I'm not going to do that right now though. But there's the answer to that question. Real quick, before I go into question number four, before I get there, a couple easy items in here. I expanded this. Anyone with this link can edit. Be careful with that one. Only share this with people you trust and tell them not to share the link. This is one I see all the time. People in Chris Menard Training. That's my tenant or organization. You'll see your company name there with the link can use this. Some companies do not allow you to share files with people outside your organization or company, just so you know that. People with existing access or access to this folder already. And specific people, I get asked this question, but I didn't include it today. Well, where do I specify who can edit this file? When I hit apply, now you would type in all their emails at one time right here. I'm going to close that out, so I didn't do it. So there we go with that feature there. And again, click. Real quick, OneDrive Worker School, OneDrive Personal. Allow editing or not allow editing is there. Expire is there in both of them. Set password is there in both of them. If you set a password, you have to email the person the password or text it to them. call them and give it to them. The password does not go in the link or the email that you send to them. And then block download is only for worker school. Perfect. Number four, how can I tell who I have shared files with? Multiple methods. One of the easiest is to pull up File Explorer. I already have it running here. I'm in my OneDrive Chris Menard training. I'm in a folder called Braves. Notice there is a little person next to that cloud. That means I've shared that file. The file above it, that's a Word document, I have not shared. But let me show you something even cool inside of OneDrive if you don't want to go there. If I go to Shared over here to the left, I've got two tabs at the top. Shared with you, these are all the files that have been shared with me. But there is Shared by you. There are all the files that I've shared. Notice that Excel file is not sitting up here. Let's go back to Files. I'm going to actually share this file real quick. Share. Just keep this simple. Anyone with the link, that sounds good. Apply. They can edit too. You don't have to copy the link. This is how you would select the link and copy it and then send it to them. So now I've shared that file. So now when I go to Shared, Shared by you. How about a quick refresh? Shared by you. There it is sitting right up there. So I can tell all the files that I have shared with people. By the way, from here, and this is actually the last question, how can I remove sharing access to a file? If you click here, you want to hit Manage Access. So I don't care if you do it here. Manage Access is also back here. Manage Access. It'll always appear over on the right-hand side of your window. And there is Stop Sharing. And if I hit Stop Sharing, let's just test this. Stop Sharing. Perfect. Back to Shared. I'm going to do a quick refresh. Shared by you. No longer shared. That's all I have. I hope you enjoyed this video. I love Microsoft OneDrive because I'm using Microsoft 365 most of the time. It allows you to do versioning. It allows you to retrieve documents that are in your recycle bin. Your recycle bin holds items for 93 days, in case you're wondering. You can pull them back. Your admin may have changed that or not. I don't know. Let me know if you have any comments or questions. Feel free to subscribe. Thank you for your time.